Now, I've done several videos related to why someone might have a loss of smell, the underlying cause, whether it's related to a virus or some other cause. I have some new information I want to share with you on restoring your sense of smell. Now, in some recent research that I've been looking at, there's some interesting data on insulin. Insulin is needed to repair the olfactory neurons, okay? Now, what you need to know is the olfactory neurons have everything to do with your receptors for smell, which, if damaged, can majorly affect your ability to taste by like a factor of 80%. So, if you can't smell, you're not going to be able to taste too well. And the interesting data about this, which I'll put a link down below, is this. The highest density and the highest concentration of insulin receptors in the brain are in the olfactory region of the brain, okay? Now, this probably relates to the link between insulin and the storage of food, like fat, and smell and taste related to appetite. And so insulin has a huge role in the recovery of neurons after an injury, okay? So it has everything to do with regenerating the olfactory neurons. And so if there is not enough insulin available, you're gonna have a hard time recovering from any type of injury to these neurons. And this is why a diabetic and a pre-diabetic are hit a lot harder with the sense of smell after damaging those neurons than someone that doesn't have a problem with insulin. I mean, if you even think about diabetics, they also have a problem with losing their eyesight, right? Well, they can also lose their sense of smell. Now, you might be saying, well, I'm not a diabetic, I'm not pre-diabetic. Well, chances are you may have insulin resistance, which is a lot more common. In fact, probably 70% of the population has insulin resistance, which means you may have an insulin deficiency on certain parts of your body, as well as an insulin excess. But as far as the neurons in the olfactory area in your sinuses, chances are you could be very deficient in insulin if you have insulin resistance. So then I started doing research on intranasal insulin spray, okay? I wanted to know if there's any relationship between spraying insulin into the sinuses, directly affecting the olfactory bulb, which is in your sinuses, and to see if there's any improvement in smell. And sure enough, with just 40 units spraying up into your sinuses, there was an immediate improvement in the sense of smell and smell differentiation between different odors. There's many different things you can do with a loss of smell. You can start taking zinc. There are certain types of essential oils that give off certain scents that you can retrain your olfactory neurons. But restoring insulin resistance, so you have enough insulin to help repair these neurons, I think is going to be probably the most important thing to do. Now, I've done a ton of videos on insulin resistance, as you may know already if you're on my channel. But if you haven't watched my videos, I think this is going to be very important for you to know. Or if you just want to improve your sense of smell, number one, you have to go on a low carb diet. Number two, intermittent fasting is a must, okay? At least fasting of 18 hours. And if you're new to my channel, I put a link down below of how to do this correctly. Apple cider vinegar before bed, like 2 tablespoons and some water, would be very, very beneficial to help with insulin resistance. Any type of exercise, regular exercise, is going to help you with insulin resistance. Vitamin D, at least 10,000 IUs per day, can help you with insulin resistance. Enough potassium, either in a supplement or potassium foods, is going to be very important in restoring insulin resistance. And enough vitamin B1 can also help. And so the more you improve insulin resistance, the more you're going to have normal insulin, the more you're going to have the ability to restore these neurons if they're damaged. All right, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Hey, before you go, if you're benefiting from any of my content, I would love to hear about your success story. Please share it in the link down below.